Alright guys, welcome back to the channel. In this video we will see how we can download and install CodeBlocks IDE and MinGW, which will provide the C++ compilers or the toolset, and then we will see how we can set them up so that we can write and execute C++ programs. Now here I will download and install CodeBlocks IDE and MinGW separately. First we will see how we can download and install MinGW. Then we will see how we can install CodeBlocks and how we can run a C program. So here, let us see how we can download and install MinGW. So what you have to do is, you have to open up any browser that is installed in your computer. I have Microsoft Edge. I'm going to open it up. And here in the URL bar, we will enter the website address as winlibs.com and we will open up the website. So here we can see that we will get the standalone build for GCC and MinGW. Now here you can read through all these things and understand more about this. What we do is we will go down to the download section, and here we can find the release versions. So we will download under this UCRT runtime, and we will download whatever the latest version that is available, and we will download it with the POSIX threads. Okay, so here now we can see that we have the option to download for Windows 32-bit operating system and Windows 64-bit operating system. So depending on the operating system that is installed in your computer, you can choose a download option in here. Now here I will go with the Windows 64-bit and zip archive, and I will click on this, and once I click on that, the download will begin. We have to wait for this download to finish. Okay, now the download is complete. If I take the cursor on this downloaded file, then I can see this folder icon. If I click on that, it will open up the folder where the downloaded files are saved, generally in the downloads folder. And here we can see that this is a zip file that is downloaded. So what we do is we will right click here on this file and we will click on extract all. And we have to select the location where we want to install it. So here we will click on this browse, and then I will go to this PC, and here local disk C drive, and here I will extract these files. So I will select this C drive and I will click on this select folder just like this, and we will check this option which says show extracted files when complete. And then we will click on this extract. Now it will start extracting the files. Again, we have to wait for this to complete. Okay, now the extraction is complete, and once the extraction is complete, it will open up the folder where all these files are extracted. If you remember, we have extracted the files in the C drive. So in this C drive, we can see a folder created with the name MinGW64, and this is a folder which contains all the extracted files. So now what we have done is we have downloaded MinGW and we have saved those files in the computer. But in order to access them from any folder in the file system, we have to update the path environment variable with the location of the C and C++ compilers, and these programs are present inside this MinGW64 folder. So what we do is we will open up the folder where all the extracted files are present, in this case this C drive and this MinGW64 folder. We will open it up. We can see this bin folder in here. We will open this up, and now here we can see all these programs present. For example, you can see that we have GCC, which is a C compiler, G++, which is a C++ compiler, all these programs, and GDB, which is a debugger. All these programs are present here. So what we have to do is we have to copy the path of this particular location. One simple trick that we can do is if we take the cursor on this top navigation section, and if we left click here, it will highlight the path like this: C, MinGW64, bin folder. We will right click and copy this path. Once we copy this path, we can minimize this explorer window, and then we will click on the start button and we will search for edit environment variables for your account. So we will click on this option. It will open up this edit environment variables section, and here in this user variables section we can find path. We will select by clicking on that, and then we will click on edit, and here we will click on new, and then we will paste the path that we have copied just like that, and then we will click on OK, and then we will click on OK. So now, in order to check everything is properly installed, we will click on the start button, search for CMD, and we will open up the command prompt, and here we will check the version of GCC installed. To do that, we will type in GCC space minus minus version, and now you can see the version of GCC that is installed in this computer. Similarly, we can check G++ space minus minus version of G++ that is installed, and again we can check the version of GDB, that is the debugger. So it will be GDB space minus minus version, and here we can see the version of GDB. Okay, so now once C and C++ toolset or MinGW is installed in our computer, we can go ahead and we can download and install CodeBlocks IDE. So now I will open up a browser. I have Microsoft Edge, and here we will search for CodeBlocks IDE, and the website address is codeblocks.org. We will click on this search result. It will open up this official website for CodeBlocks, and here we can straight away see this downloads option. We will click on that. And now in this downloads page, we can see this download the binary release. We will click on this. And then if we scroll down, we can find the download options for Windows, Linux, and macOS. Here in this Windows section, we can see a lot of download options. Now here, I will not download the option which says CodeBlocks, version number, and then MinGW. The reason for that is we have already installed MinGW in our computer, and there is no need of installing it here. Now, the reason why I installed CodeBlocks and MinGW separately and not by using this particular option is, with the option which says CodeBlocks with MinGW here, we will get the older version of C++ compilers, but the method that I have explained here in this video, it will get you the latest version of C and C++ toolchain. So now, since MinGW is already installed in our computer, we will click on this option which says CodeBlocks and then the version number setup.exe. So I will download it from FOSS Hub, and the download will begin. Now if the download doesn't begin automatically, then you can see the download options here. You can download CodeBlocks Windows 64-bit. Now here, lot of other options are also available. Depending on your need, you can download the version. Here I have downloaded CodeBlocks Windows 64-bit. So once the download is complete, we can see the folder icon in here. If I click on that, it will open up the folder where the downloaded files are saved, generally in the downloads folder, and we can see the file here. We will double click on this file and install it. If it asks for the permission, then click on yes and provide the permission. Now the installation window will open. We will click on this next. We will agree the license agreement. We will not change anything in here. We will click on next. We will click on this install. Now the CodeBlocks will be installed. We will wait. Okay, now once CodeBlocks is installed, it says, do you want to run it? We will click on yes, and then we will click on next, and we will click on this finish. Now I will minimize all other programs. Now the CodeBlocks IDE is opening. Now it will automatically detect the compiler that is installed in the computer, and you just have to click on continue or next. It will take you to this particular page. Now if the compiler is not recognized, for some reason, then you have to make sure that you have you have installed MinGW properly. As I have explained, you have to follow every step. And now here what we do is we will create a simple project. I will click on this create new project. I will select console application, click on go, click on next. I will select C as a programming language, click on next. I will give a title. I will say hello world, and here I will select the folder where I want to save my project, and then I will click on next, and then I will click on finish. Now here in this management window, we can see the project. In this sources folder, we can see this main.c. If I double click on that, it will open up the file and we can see the code written in here. Now we will see how we can run this. In this top section, we can find build, and here we can find build and run, or you guys can use the keyboard and press the F9 key. Once we click on that, the program will be compiled and then it will be run. So here we can see the output of this particular program, which says hello world. So this is it, guys. This is how we can download and install CodeBlocks IDE along with MinGW, and this is how we can run a simple program. So thank you for watching. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you don't like it, hit the dislike button. If you have anything to say, write that in the comment box. For more tutorials like this, subscribe to the channel.